An iconic and centuries-old brand of breakfast foods is acknowledging its origins are based on a racial stereotype and it's going away for good. Quaker Oats is retiring its famed Aunt Jemima line of food products, and the company, which is now owned by PepsiCo, has marketed pancake mix, grits, syrup, with the face of a black woman since it took over the brand in 1926. The original logo from the 1800s used the very racist mammy stereotype of a smiling, full-figured black woman who was wearing a headscarf. Over the years, this look was changed, but the name remained, a name that came from a minstrel show tune reportedly sung by slaves. In a statement, Quaker Oats said this about making the change, quote, "As we work to make progress toward racial equality through several initiatives, we also must take a hard look at our portfolio of brands and ensure they reflect our values and meet our consumers' expectations." And then another iconic food product using racial tropes, Uncle Ben's, will also disappear. Its owner, the Mars Company, announced that it plans to evolve, that's a quote, that's the word they used, the food line's brand and, quote, visual identity. A new name and logo have not yet been decided. Dan Gasby is a restaurateur and co-partner of the iconic lifestyle brand B. Smith Enterprises. And I want to get your reaction to this, because you actually called on Quaker Oats several years ago to change the logo because you had said it was, quote, the epitome of female humiliation. They told you that they would never do it. Now they have. What do you think?
Well, first of all, Brianna, thank you for having me. It's something that is a blessing. We're at a tectonic shift in our country about racial relationships and understanding how we're going to all get along. And it has been something that, let me just say, my wife, the late Barbara Smith, was in a store. We were trying to develop a supermarket business, and she asked a young black girl who was happened to buy well over a decade ago a box of pancake syrup with Aunt Jemima, and B walked up to her and says, "Hello, do you know who this image is?" And the young lady basically said it was someone who's very important. And that was something that, you know, struck her as being unbelievably sad, that she didn't know that this really represented something negative. And so that was the start of Barbara B. Smith wanting to make sure that young girls, particularly young African-American girls, would not have the situation where they would have stereotypes that were showing not the best of them, but showing the history of slavery.
Stereotypes are powerful. They have long-lasting effects. And an example of that, in this case with Aunt Jemima, something that happened to one of your waitresses. Tell us about this, a customer actually calling your waitress Aunt Jemima.
It still hurts me to this day. We had a restaurant in Sag Harbor, and we were sitting on the deck. I was actually at the bar, and a group of guys came in, and our waitress, who was very large, was serving them, and she was called Aunt Jemima. And two separate tables shows you how things work out. One table that was predominantly black and another table that was predominantly white overheard the conversation and literally made those people leave. It's been a historic situation. We started this well over a decade plus ago. And I said to PepsiCo, to the people there who was the head of global marketing, I said, no one would want to get an Aunt Jemima award. You can't give a scholarship in the name of Aunt Jemima. You could give a scholarship in the name of Mrs. Butterworth, and it would have more value, because there's not a single black girl in America wants to be called Aunt Jemima. I said, if you could imagine someone saying to your daughter, you know, you remind me of Aunt Jemima, or saying, you know, you embody the very talents of Aunt Jemima, they would be insulted. And it met upon deaf ears over a decade ago. And I am now so proud of this young lady named Kirby. You know, the future is for the young. And what she did with social media is what's changing the course of our country for the better. You know, there's a real shout out to Kirby for making this thing so millennials and people younger can see how difficult it is to be called the N-word is the same as to be called Aunt Jemima. And so I'm very proud of what she did, and I'm proud of what my wife had represented long before it was falling on deaf ears, the need to change and make this image go away and to find a suitable image that would be respected and admired and inspiring for others.
Dan Gaspy, thank you so much for sharing your thoughts today. We really appreciate it.
My pleasure, Brianna. Thank you for having me.